So, Chris, as I was walking here along, let's say, Lafayette Street or Center Street, one of those.
Okay.
I pass a giant billboard, and it says something like T-Mobile something or other.
Like an advert.
An advert, exactly. Coming to you faster than the latest release hits Canal Street on DVD. Very funny. Very funny little ad.
I get what they're saying then.
In the ad is the Apple, the T-Mobile girl. Are you familiar with the T-Mobile girl? T-Mobile has a new spokesmodel.
Oh, the that kind of pretty girl who wears a pink dress?
She always wears a pink dress or a pink something or other.
I know exactly who she is.
And she's basically, they're basically mocking the Apple commercials, the I'm PC, I'm Mac, and they're doing that by making Apple's product, the iPhone, like the lame one, like PC, Mac was the cool, hip guy, and PC was the lame guy because he wore a suit.
So, wait, so they're not mocking it, they're kind of like doing an homage.
They're doing an homage, but they are now making the Apple was the originator of that commercial. They're now putting Apple in the lame position, and the iPhone is now the lame one. And anyway, the commercials aren't very good. Obviously, no commercials are, but
I remember that there's a pretty girl with a pink dress in them.
Well,
that means something, doesn't it?
There's a specific one where she says, now, me and you have talked in the past about how angry I get.
That's
we've texted.
We've never spoken.
I once wrote you a letter, but I haven't mailed it yet. But in it, I don't want you to know about it. But in it, I told you how angry I get at commercials. I get a little too angry at commercials, more than I should.
You do?
Usually you tell me why you're watching commercials, just fast forward. But
TiVo.
You can't always do that.
You could have TiVo.
I have a
TiVo. It's 2011.
I like live TV.
By the way, 2011 TV. My TV broke for the third time. Just saying that, putting that out there. I no longer have an HD 50-inch TV in my room. I have in my living room. I have a big black box that just doesn't do anything in my living room.
Do you have a TV at all?
The third time. Yeah, I have the small one that I used to have. Like 28-inch or something, 27-inch.
I don't have a high definition TV anymore either because
I just figured out how to get it set up again. Because I had all my PlayStation, all the games and crap set up to it, and I had no idea how to do it.
When I bought my high def TV in Best Buy, it was like a really cheap one, and somebody told me, it'll probably last you maybe like 4 years, but after that, it's probably not going to work well. And it lasted me 4 years, and then 4 years later, I realized how much it sucked that it was only going to last 4 years. But I just assumed at the time I bought it that I would be alive in 4 years.
Exactly.
Or I'd be a billionaire, either or. Six or one, bro.
Exactly, yeah. Well, I'm trying to say that, in my mind, I'm trying to convince myself, I got my money's worth out of it. I've had this TV like a year. Maybe a little more, maybe a year and a half. I've had my TV.
Yeah, I remember you talking about your new TV.
It hasn't been 2 years, and I'm trying to be like, I got my money's worth out of it because I bought it used.
You watched one show.
Yes, exactly.
You saw the last episode.
Lost. It was good though. It was good. What was that? What was that whole thing with that guy with the hair?
I know who you're talking about, the guy in the Apple commercial.
Right.
The T-Mobile commercial.
Right.
So anyway, on this commercial, there's a new one, and she says, T-Mobile, whatever, I'm not even going to pretend to know what they're talking about on the commercial, but she's talking about like scientific features on one of the new phones, and she says, I brought a friend of mine here to tell me about it, and the friend is this skinny white kid that raps with like a wool hat, and he raps.
I just want you to know, if we would have thought this out when you said she brought a friend with him at that moment, if Fred came walking across there right now, that would have been the best thing ever.
Why'd you ruin it?
I'm sorry.
He's been suffocating back there for no reason.
That's right. Anyway.
And the guy just comes out and starts rapping. And, you know, like, obviously, I don't even think you need to know how aggravating this guy rapping is, but he's rapping, and he's rapping real fast, and
like a Duke?
The thing, exactly. A Duke bag.
Okay.
And the thing that drives me crazy about it is that the entire time, this girl that's like this big, confident cocksure, if you will, spokesperson for T-Mobile, all of a sudden gets all shy because this douchebag with the wool hat is rapping, and like they're showing her like flip her hair and put her head down and blush. It really was the closest thing I've ever come to kicking my TV.
Oh, so it wasn't making fun, like it was cool that he was rapping.
Oh, no, yeah, this commercial, it's cool that he's rapping, and then he's like, we do this? And she says something like, yeah, we did it. You get all that? Sorry, I'm just getting mad even thinking about it right now. The fact that commercials and this, there's now, I know you listen to the radio, the fact that commercials exist.
I love that you still hate commercials. That's what's happened.
Why? You thought I suddenly liked them now?
No, I think it's like, you know, we had to come out here today and let everybody know Keith still doesn't like commercials. All right? I think our message is clear.
The message is clear. Do not get me any commercials.
Awesome.
Unless it's for ICU2.com.
ICU2.com. Come on.